My name is Ho Jia Hui and my matric number is 261589. So today I will present CBD component model. There are three elements of component model, which are interface, usage information, and deployment and use. And each of the elements have three sub elements. So in our group G, we have chosen two component models to present, which are Enterprise Java Bean model, EJB, and .NET model. And me, Ho Jia Hui, I will introduce EJB. So what is EJB? EJB is a server-side software component that used to develop scalable, robust, and secure enterprise application in Java. So to run an EJB application, you need an application server, or we call as EJB container, such as JBoss, Glassfish, WebLogic, and WebSphere. So there are three types of EJB, which are session bean, message driven bean, and entity bean. So the disadvantage of EJB also have three. First one, as I mentioned just now, you need application server to run an EJB model, which is not so efficient. And secondly, it requires only Java clients. EJB, the full name is Enterprise Java Bean, so it is a Java programming language. So it requires only Java client. However, if you are using another programming language and you are interested to using EJB model, you can use it, but you need to go for web service. So the last one is EJB is complex to understand and develop. So this is the EJB architecture, and here is two pictures. Actually, it's the same. What different is this is 2D and this is 3D. And as you can see, there are application server to run the EJB, and there is an EJB container inside the application server, and the object is inside the EJB container. So application server. Application server is the outermost layer that holds or contains the container to be deployed, which means it's very important to execute the application deployed using the beans. And there are some popular application servers such as WebLogic, Tomcat, and JBoss. And the main tasks of application server are manage interface, execution of the processes, connecting to the database, and manage other resources. Well, in EJB container is the second outermost layer. It provides various supporting services. So therefore, container is quite important for EJB model. It provides support for transaction service, such as register the object, assign remote interface, and purge the instance. It provides support for monitoring the object activities and coordinating distributed components. And third, it provides support for security service. And fourth, it provides pooling resources. It also provides managing the lifecycle of bean and their concurrency. And last, container provides support to concentrate on business logic. As I mentioned just now, there are three types of EJB model, which are session beans, the message driven, and entity. So first is session beans. Session beans is the most generated type of enterprise bean. There are three types of session bean lifecycle, which determined by the bean state. The first one is stateless session beans, stateful session beans, and singlet session beans. The only difference between stateless session beans and stateful session beans is stateful session beans maintain data, and it maintains the state of client across multiple requests, while stateless does not maintain data. For singlet session bean, it only contain one client. This is the difference of the bean state. Second, the message-driven bin. Message-driven bin, MDB, is a bin that contains business logic, but is invoked by passing the message. So it is like a JMS receiver. As therefore, if you want to use a message-driven bin, you need to have the knowledge of JMS API. And yeah, and this is the figure to show the architecture with message-driven bin. So the last one is entity bin. Entity bin represent the persistent data stored in the database. It is a server-side component. And there are two types of entity bin, which are bin managed persistent and container managed persistent. So here is the picture about relationship of enterprise server bins to Java object in entity bin. So just now we introduced the basic of knowledge about EJB, and now we introduce about the component model, the element of component model of EJB. First one, interface. So there are two interfaces in EJB, which are the home interface and the remote interface. The EJB component has home interface, which defines the method of creating, initializing, destroying, and in case of the entity bin, finding EJB instance on the server. So in conclusion, in summary, the home interface is creating server-side bins, while remote interface using the server-side bin. So in this picture, you can see the home interface, the remote, the home creating the bin, and the remote using the bin. So secondly, go to the usage information. So in user information, I'm choosing naming conversation, because naming conversation is important for enterprise bin, as enterprise bin are composed of multiple parts, and it is useful to follow a naming conversation for people to deploy using EJB. So this is table of naming conversation of enterprise bin. This. And lastly, deployment and use. So there are few steps of EJB deployment process. So first one is get the bin from EJB developer, and which include the home and remote interface and all the naming conversation, and has been compiled and put into a jar file. One jar file for one bin. Okay. After complete this, the next step is develop a deployment descriptor for each bin. And after finish this, the team need to run the deployment tool, which with the deployment descriptor and the bar Jafin, loads the bin, publishing in the bin in the bin home interface. And last, the team need to make sure that the application developer has the information he or she needs about the bin remote interface and the name of publisher's bin for documentations and for the next person who use it. So there are four steps. Okay. So thank you for listening to me about my presentation on EJB. And sorry for any words that I'm using, and bye bye.